हेलो व्यूअर्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल। टुडे आई एम शेयरिंग अ परफेक्ट ब्रेकफास्ट रेसिपी विद यू। इट्स ए स्टफ पराठा। स्टफ पराठा इज अ वेरी कॉमन ब्रेकफास्ट इन द इंडिया, बट दिस पराठा इज रिच इन प्रोटीन, मिनरल्स, विटामिन्स, बिकॉज आई मेड इट विद द ब्रोकली, पनीर एंड चीज। सो पराठा कैन बी मेक अ हेल्दियर वे। Some people find it difficult to make a stuffed paratha properly when they use the stuffing. Either it's come out or otherwise they need to use a less stuffing. So I will be sharing our trick and tips with you to make a perfect stuffed paratha. If you are new to my channel, please like and subscribe my channel and share with your friends also. Broccoli is very good in nutritional value. It has lots of vitamins, potassium, calcium, fiber. So we should include it in our diet. Some people don't like the broccoli taste, I just try to make it in a paratha form. And this type of recipe goes well with everybody in my house. So I thought of sharing with you. So let's start the recipe. First, I took the one broccoli flower. I just cut into the small floret and I just washed it properly 3-4 times. We should clean it very, very nicely. Broccoli, you should clean very nicely. Or then I just kept it for the drain so that all the extra water it came out. The other ingredient what I used is the chopped onion, green chili, the spring onion, ginger garlic paste, some lemon juice. This is a 200 gram paneer which I grated later. You can use the cheddar cheese. I had a mozzarella cheese, so I used that, and I used the little less cheese in my paratha. You can add it more. In spices, you can add according to your taste. I use the coriander powder, turmeric powder, red chili powder, salt, garam masala, black pepper, chaat masala, and some little oil or ghee for the paratha we require. So this is all the our requirement. First we will prepare our stuffing for the paratha. For that I just grated the paneer. And then broccoli also you should in the grater or with the chopper you can make it into the fine pieces, like I just did like that. This is our broccoli. After the chopper, I used with this chopper for this. And the if you are using cheese, so you should grate the cheese also. And other ingredients are already ready in a pan. We will take little oil, then some little cumin seeds we will add into this. Just saute the cumin seed, then we will add the onion, chopped onion what we have, and green chilies to this oil. We'll cook it for a while till it become little translucent, and then we will add the ginger garlic paste and mix it well. So till the you just see the raw smell of garlic should be gone. This is done. It take only 2-3 minutes, not more than that. Then we will add the broccoli and on high flame we will cook it, just because we want to cook it so that if the extra water is there, so that should be evaporate. That's the only reason we are cooking it like this. And broccoli we will add the all spices what we are using. I use red chili powder, black pepper powder, little chaat masala and turmeric powder, garam masala. But this masalas you can anytime change according to your taste. Even if you will add only the salt, pepper and lemon juice, because the paneer and cheese will give the nice taste, so you can make with that also. Later on we will add paneer and mix it well. Everything should be well mixed. In the last we will add the spring onion to this. When the mixture is little cool, then we will add our cheese. Otherwise cheese will melt at this time only if we will add when the mixture is hot, so it will be very sticky. So I just, after cooling down, I just added this cheese to this mixture. Now our stuffing is ready. To prepare a dough for the paratha, we will use whole wheat flour. In this flour we will add little salt and carom seed, and with the use of water we will make a soft dough. This is the main thing you should consider when you are making the dough. It should be soft and pliable when we are making the stuffed paratha or anything stuffed, because if you will make the hard dough, then it will be difficult to roll it with the stuffing, and if it will be not rolled properly and your stuffing will come out from the side. Or otherwise people, to avoid this, they just use the less stuffing and the more dough. तो देट ऑल्सो डोंट सॉल्व अवर पर्पस एंड यू डोंट गेट द प्रॉपर स्टफ पराठा द टेस्ट वॉट यू शुड गेट वेन यू आर मेकिंग द स्टफ पराठा. तो योर डो शुड बी लेस मीन्स योर कवरिंग शुड बी थिन एंड योर स्टफिंग शुड बी मोर इन टू द पराठा टू गेट ए प्रॉपर स्टफ पराठा टेस्ट. तो जस्ट कीप इट इन माइंड डो शुड बी सॉफ्ट एंड प्लाइबल नॉट हार्ड. We after making a dough, we will keep it for the 15 to 20 minutes for resting and after that only we will start making our paratha. See, this is my dough is ready. Now I will keep it for resting for 15 and 20 minutes. Then we will start. Now we will just take a little dough, like a chapati, not more than that. Or if you want to make a big paratha, you can take little more than that, but it should not be more. Then we will just roll it little, or you can do it by the hand also. I just rolled a little, and then I just make the corner thin because all the corners will come together into the center. So that's why I just punch it to make it little thin. And now see, I just took a big ball of the stuffing, and just sealed it properly. After sealing it, firstly you should press it with your hands little bit. Don't directly use your roller to roll it. First press it little with hand so that if little air is inside that it comes out, and slowly just roll it without putting more pressure. With the light hand you should roll it so that the stuffing shouldn't come out. Then you will get a proper stuffed paratha. You can see this is the paratha what I rolled. Now I just cooking it. I will use some cooking oil. I use very less oil when I make the paratha. I have a habit because I don't want to use too much oil or ghee in my food. If you want, you can use little more oil or ghee as per your taste, but for me this much is enough. And just don't cook it on the very high flame. It should be the medium flame to medium to slow. Sometime when if you want a crispy paratha, and just cook it on that flame. So this is the main small points you should keep it in your mind when you are making a paratha. Hope these tricks will help you to solve your problem if you are facing in making stuffed parathas. Let me know your feedback and. See, just cook paratha from the both the side. This is my tawa which I use only to make the paratha. That's why you can see it's a little black and see because all oily things comes on this. So I keep the chapati and the paratha tawa separately. So you can also do this. This also help to keep your utensils proper. After making the paratha, you just roll all the parathas like that and make what is stuffing and measurement I just shared. I just made it with the 8 parathas with all this mixture. This mixture you can use it for to make the sandwiches also. You can use this stuffing as a sandwich. This paratha, if you are having in breakfast, you can serve it with the pickle. You can have some cheese spread with this, or you can serve it with the yogurt. It's up to your choice. You can have some with some chutneys, whatever. So this is how my paratha looks. I use little less cheese. If you want more cheesy, you can add more cheese to this, but for me this is the way I can make the healthiest paratha. So I just use this. Hope you like my recipe. If you like my recipe, please subscribe my channel, hit the bell button to get the notification, and like the video and share with your friends. Thank you so much for watching.